Y'all, I am so excited to share with you CometAI, which is brought to us by Enterprise Technology Innovation Services. They've been busily working on this so that we can have access to multiple AI models as we prompt and engage. I'm going to give a quick walkthrough and share with you some of the differences that you're going to experience using this tool as opposed to Copilot. This is far more robust, far more interactive, and you can do a lot more customizations. Okay, let's log in. I've already logged in today. This is backed with SSO. So when you first log in, you are going to have to authenticate through Duo to get on. So you can see as I log in, it's very similar UI to what we already experienced with Copilot. For our purposes, I'm going to start from left to right as I introduce this platform to you so that you can understand how to work with it and how it varies just so slightly. All of the conversations that you have are going to be on this left side panel. They are stamped and categorized by date, so the most recent ones being on top. What's a little bit different is that you can go in and you can change and be able to save based on whatever naming convention you would like. If you are having a particular conversation or working on a project, you can elaborate that in that folder name. Also, if there are conversations that you no longer need to keep, you can delete those conversations or name them based on what your individual prompt is. That's what happens by default. Again, all underneath that particular date. Something unique about this as well as when you're having a conversation, you can tag the conversation with what that content is about. So if you did need to go back, say we were using things for social media and using prompts over and over, I could tag that social media, then be able to go up into the search box, type in social media, any of those conversations would show up for me so I could quickly go through and gather them, because the more you use this, the more conversations you're going to have. Then again, if you need to start a new chat, it's going to pull that up in that folder for you. Okay, let's go into a little bit of the sharing. If there's conversations that you're having, there's prompts that you've worked on, creating something, you are able to share that out to somebody. You do need to add them in based on their UT Dallas email. It only shares with UT Dallas people, so you can't send it to external folks. You would add in their email, quick note, and then you can select which particular conversation you're wanting to share, then send that to them. We're going to take a very quick look at some of the settings because this is where so much of the customization and personalization can happen using this tool. Very different than what we have in Copilot. We're going to go into the settings here and you can see these are all of the available models that are going to show by default. If there are particular models that you do not want to interact with, that you do not really have a use case for, you do have the option of simply deselecting it. When you save that, then the interface is not going to put that on the front end for you to have those interactions with. For now, I'm going to leave mine by default so that I can show and demonstrate all of them to you. If you do not like being in dark mode, you can change it, but by default, we have selected it to appear in dark mode. There are options for how you store these conversations. You should be aware that all the conversations are backed on our AWS servers. So what that means is that our conversations are not being used to train models. It's not being utilized out there where you have to be concerned about how it's going to be interpreted publicly, okay? It's all stored internally. A little bit different, but real quick, you can change how you want that stored too if you do want it in cloud or if you want it locally. By default, that's how we have it. Here's a little bit different in what we've experienced with Copilot. Each of these models requires tokens, and part of what that is that our interactions have a real cost associated with them. For our purposes of having you in this pilot program, we're requesting that you keep your spending to $3 per month. I'll show you in a minute how you can check that. It's very clear, very transparent. But for our testing purposes, we do need you to stick to that $3 per month so that we can ensure that we're within our budget for this project. Okay, so those were a quick overview of settings. Another critical component, because this is a pilot program, because we want to enhance, we want to improve. As you're using this tool, if you have positive or negative experiences, we want to know about it. We want to know what we need to change or what's working well for you. Clicking that send feedback is going to pop up an email address to CometAI. You can express any of your concerns or positive feedbacks and interactions and send an email so that we can keep a record of that. Okay, those are your settings. Middle bar, and once you're done with those, if you no longer want to see or preview them and you want to focus more on the conversation and the prompting, you can simply select the little toggle at the top, make it disappear, out of sight, out of mind. The middle portion of CometAI is where you're going to be doing your engagement, your conversations, your prompting. This is where you're going to select the different LLM that you're working with. And you can see the models by simply clicking this center section here. I'll go over briefly the different models. If you're not familiar with some of these models and how they appear, when you hover over it, there's a little prompt there that will tell you exactly what that model would be ideal for. So as you're having your conversations and your prompts, depending on what you're trying to generate, you can hover and determine which of these tools is going to best help you achieve your goals. You'll notice that each of these have a camera icon. What that is going to indicate to you is the models that will allow you to interact or will interact with images. So if you have a screenshot, an image, or something that you're needing to upload file-wise, those are the ones that you're going to use to be able to access that file and be able to read it. You also notice there's little dollar signs here. Each of these models, as I showed that chart previously, are going to have a different real cost associated with usage. So depending on what you're trying to use and what you're trying to achieve, something as simple as maybe digesting and understanding an email is very different than developing a massive project plan or a mind map, right? So depending on what you're trying to achieve, you need to determine which model is best going to help you achieve that and which expense from our budget is most necessary for your utilization. So that's where you would be able to jump and be able to select your individual models. Within the conversations that you're having, very similar to how Copilot can adjust based on your conversation, CometAI, you can adjust those as well. By default, the toggles are normally within the center. So temperature is going to set its response of how it's responding. If you're wanting precise, that would be for something highly technical, highly nuanced, very much to the point, versus creative. If you're wanting it to come up with storytelling or a broad proposal, something a bit more innovative, then that's the temperature you would set it more towards that. So depending on what you're trying to achieve, make those adjustments. As well, you can adjust the response length if you're just needing quick, rapid response, high level, bullet pointed, one or two sentences, make it concise. If you're liking my videos, then I am set to verbose. You're welcome. So depending on what settings you want, you can adjust them there. And then your interaction would go here. This is where you would enter your prompt. I just put in a general email just so that you can see. This is where your prompt interactions are going to be. Here at the very top is the icon showing your information versus the response from CometAI. And here, because I have it a little bit more verbose than concise, you can see how it's going to respond. Up at the top, this is the critical information where I did mention maintaining our budget, staying within those parameters of that $3. It will keep a tab for you of your month-to-date cost. So there's never a reason you don't know. As you generate each new response, it's going to add that to your tally, and you can see in live time what your expense is. As far as once you have a response, once you've generated something, you've worked on your prompt, you are able to copy, adjust, or download email or branch off from this conversation and start having any additional conversations. To scroll down to the bottom of the screen, you would simply navigate there. We're going to have more videos and more in-depth tutorials on the the information that's on this right side of the screen. For now, I'm not going to delve into it because really what we want you trying are the different models and seeing how each of those work, seeing how the general interface works for you. But there's more that can become that can come with this tool, such as creating custom assistants, reprogramming the prompts that you're going to be using every day. So for those things that are redundant, there's templates that we can create that we can launch. But for now, we need you to log in. We need you testing. We need you playing with this tool. Innovate, be creative. Let us know what you like, what you've learned, what you've loved. Send us that feedback, and I hope you enjoy getting to utilize Comet AI.